this session we'll be having now is product usage metrics, practical trenches from Kiran Kashyap. So he's on stage now.
Yeah, thanks for the introducing Vikram. Let me share my screen. So thank you all. Thanks for joining. Good evening and good morning to everybody from wherever you are. And before we start the topic, let me introduce myself. So I am Kiran. I work as a Scrum Master at Lowe's. And I'm also an open source contributor. And I'm a blogger. Also, I'm a conference speaker. I wherever possible, I try to share what I have learned. And I love playing badminton. And I'm a traveler. So yeah, this is my intro. So before we start the topic, the topic name is product usage metrics, right? So what exactly do we mean by product usage metrics? Let's try to understand that, and then we can then I'll share you a few stories among this topic. So here, let me try to divide this term into three. So product usage and metrics. So what is a product? Product is something which solves a problem or which gives you something of value, right? That's a product. And usage is how do you use the product? And the final term, metrics. How do we measure to use the product? So this is what product usage metrics means. So what we are going to talk for another like 15, 20 minutes is how, you know, in my experience, how we made use of, how we measured the product is being used by the customer. I think we are very well familiar how to, you know, how we build product. There are multiple processes like Scrum, Kanban, we have multiple things. But this topic is mainly around what happens after we give the product to customer, how the customer is using our product, how can we, you know, what are the insights we get based on how the customer is using the product. So this is the talk. So what I'll do, I'll share you three stories, how we made, how we measured the product being used, right? So I'll share you in the form of three stories. So let's share this story, let's assume we have a team, right? The team contains the product owner, development team, and the Scrum Master. So let's discuss the first story. So the one with the prioritization problems. So we often have this problem, like the product owner often ends up saying, you know, we have priority, but he finds it difficult to, you know, prioritize a single item if two or three high priority items are there. We often end up, you know, product owner saying, you know, all these three items are equally important, and it's difficult for me to prioritize. And I'm sure you all know there are other techniques where you can prioritize the stories. Let me this story, I'll try to share another technique which you can use to prioritize your story. So let's say we have a product and it has two features, feature one, feature two, and we have two stories here, story A and story B. So story A modifies feature one and story B modifies feature two. And both have equal business value, right? And both have equal urgency. So we often end up in this scenario where it's difficult for product owner to choose which one is important here. So what did we do here? So we started, you know, we heard about this concept called product usage metric. So what did we do? We created a data table and we started collecting metrics here. So for example, let's say feature one, we had multiple user subscription. We had a diamond kind of a customer and a silver subscription customer. So we understood that diamond customer was using the feature one on an average 350 hits per day. When I say hit, he was using the feature around 350 times per day. And the same feature was also used by the silver customer. And that was around 450 hits each day. So like this, we started collecting data for all the features, right? And it also based on the user category, whether he's a diamond customer or a silver customer. So as we started, and another point to add here is we didn't find much change in performance while we were collecting data. So as we started collecting data, we generated a report, which was something like this. So we understood that more number of users are using feature one more than feature two. So it was way more. The feature one was used way more than feature two, irrespective of whether the customer was, you know, diamond subscription or a silver subscription. So this helped the product owner to sort of help his prioritization problems. Now product owner has two options. So he knows feature one is being used more. Let me try to improve the feature one so that user can have better experience, because he is using the feature one more now. And another way the product owner can think is, I see the feature two is not used much at all. Is it because the feature itself is like that, or it's not used much, or is it because it's not so friendly, that is why the user is not using it? So here the product owner can get more insights, and then he can decide which particular story he can pick it up. I mean, can he prioritize the story which changes the feature one, or can he pick up the story which modifies the feature? And it did not stop there. What did product owner do? He went on, he went to use it even better. So what did he do? He understood there is a customer X who is very important to us, right? And his renewal is ending this month. Let us prioritize feature one, because he uses this feature more. Let us try to make it better, and it gives us more probability of retaining the customer. And it is another way, this is the extension of the first story, where product owner leveraged that data we got. So there ends our feature one. And let's discuss the story two. So this story is around how it, the cultural aspect of how this metrics helped us to do better. So it helped us to motivate developers. How did we do it? There was a time where we received an email from the customer saying, thanks a lot, this feature saves at least 10 minutes of manual work time I was doing. And while the time it reached developers were saying, we never knew it. We never knew we are adding this much value to the customer. So what happened here? You know, the product owner gave vision and helped the importance. All these things were good enough for the developer. But adding to that, this can add even more motivation to developers when they see value of their work, actual value, where it is helping the customer, right? So what did we do? We took it one level more, and we started generating reports. Something like this. So what did we do? We displayed this. We started collecting how much time for each feature the customer is saving. For example, because of this particular story or this particular product or feature, we were able to help customer save 10 minutes every time he uses it, or 5 minutes every time he uses it. So we started adding the time each time the user uses it. So this was displayed out in the open, wherever the developers sit in the office, so they can see it every time, and it makes them visible of how they are actually adding value to the business, right? This helped the developers to contribute even more, and it motivated them. They got to see their actual value, what they were adding. And all these graphs which you are seeing right now, it's the graph which you are seeing. This helped. We took it from the Grafana, so it helps us to generate all these kind of graphs. So So let me see how much time do we have. Okay. Yeah. So let's discuss one more story before we end. So another story, what we did was, so the product owner was a little confused. So how did we help to clear the confusion of the product owner? You hear the confused word I'm using, not in a negative sense. So the product owner wanted to make sure the best value comes. He can get the best value of the work done by the developers. So in that term, he was sort of confused what can give the best value. So there was a particular feature. What it did was it gives the user to configure an email and then send out. You might have heard this feature like called as email campaigns. So where user can perform the email campaigns. So what he does is he'll just put a lot of email recipients in the to column, and then he goes to the email body, fills in the relevant information, and this is how the flow goes. Now the product owner was stuck. Which approach to follow? Why? Because we had two solutions right in front of us, and both solutions seem good. So the solution A was, let's say screen one enter email recipients, and screen two draft the email body. This is how the screen goes in the solution A. And the solution B was, first let us show him that to draft the email body in the first screen, and later we'll ask the user to enter the email recipients. So here both solutions seemed good, but we were not sure which one to take. So here we had to consider either one of them. We had two options. We can either consider either one based on just gut feel or experience, or the other way around is we can decide this solution based on the actual data we get. So what we did was we requested some beta users to use both these solutions. For example, beta users, I mean they are actual users, but they were willing to help us in testing or to check some features if they are okay with it, or to get their feedback. So these are set of beta users where we requested them to use both the solutions. How we did was, we had one set of beta users, we requested them to use only the solution A. And we had another set of beta users, we requested them to use only solution B. Now, the next step, how do we know which solution was better? What we did was, if the solution is good, what we did is we asked both the set of beta users to raise a support ticket whenever they have a concern, right? So the concern can be anything, whether they are not understanding the new feature or there is slowness we just can't use it, this is not user friendly. Whatever they feel, raise a support ticket. So what we did was, whichever solution gets more number of support tickets, we will ignore it. We will take the solution which was quite natural for the for the beta users to use, which was more user friendly. And what we understood, the solution B beta users were raising more number of tickets, right? So we understood that let's go with the solution A, because people are, it looks like the beta users are getting along with it pretty well without raising any support tickets. And also, whatever the support tickets were being raised for solution A, right, we also went through the tickets and we understood what problems they are facing even in that. And even that changes we made in our feature, and then we were able to give it to the actual customers. So, yeah, here it is. So thank you all for listening. Let's hear if you have any questions there.
Hey, Kiran, thanks a lot. That was awesome. We have some questions. I guess you can, there's one under Q&A, but there are a bunch of discussion going on in the audience itself. Yeah. You can probably go through them and answer them as.
Yeah, I'm looking at them. In case of difficult or legacy customers, we don't get any feedback from them. They just want to get their work done. What do you suggest? So is this question for the third scenario? Yes, yes, okay. So here we can, so one is we will have somebody from the product business side, right? Like the product owner will be representing from the business. We can either create a relationship with the product owner and explain him how to get in the beta users, how to get in the actual users to help you along. Or if not, you know, we can talk to even the leaders and explain them this problem. There is no, I would say there is no clear-cut solution here. We'll have to create a relationship. It all depends on how good relationship we have with the management, with the leaders. And if you are a scrum master, maybe you can coach the product owner to help the actual users, to help us. Or if you are in management, you can directly talk to the business and see, get sort things out. Yeah. So did I answer your question? Or was it any helpful? Sorry, I didn't get your name there. Yes. Shashi, yeah, Sakshi. Yeah, there is no clear-cut answer there. We'll have to just trial and error. This is all. That's A-B testing, Ritesh. Yes, that's A-B testing. You can call it A-B testing. Meenu, how such metrics can be built on a product where we have multiple customer and they require their customized version? Maybe we can create multiple tables for creating graph. That's a good question. Even I need to explore there, Meenu. What tools did you use to collect the analytical? So the tools was Grafana, right? The table we added, once we got the data on the data table, we used Grafana to create all the graph. Yeah. Any other questions from anyone?
All right.
Okay. Thank you so much for giving a platform to talk. Thank you, Vikram, and thank you, Ajay.